Okay, what's up, you guys? So, today I'm going to be doing a book club, as in, I don't really like to read, but I do read because, how else are you going to learn things? But also, I don't like to read because I get headaches, because I have astigmatism, and it gives me migraines. It's a whole thing. And it kind of puts me to sleep, honestly. So, I'm all about Kindles. That kind of tends to help me in my eyes. So, it's really not that I don't like to read, it's just that. It's kind of hard to read with my eye problem, so I'm gonna go ahead and pick some random parts of this book that I like, and let's have a little chit chat about it. Let's talk about it. Wow, my glasses are so dirty. Can you? Oh my God. Okay, let me just clean those 1 second. So the book is called The Compound Effect. And it's by Darren Hardy. It's Jumpstart Your Income, Your Life, Your Success. So this is kind of obviously like a self-help book. This isn't like fantasy. It's just how to, be successful. So for any of those girl bosses out there, boss babes, male or female, that are trying to kickstart their career or do something different other than working 9 to 5 for the rest of your life, then this book is for you. So that seems good. Let's start here. Time is of the essence. The earlier you start making small changes, the more powerful the compound effect works in your favor. We should have read what the compound effect is. That's fine. We're gonna keep going. Suppose your friend listened to David Ramsey's advice and began putting $250 a month into an IRA. Okay, this is way too much. No. Let's do another random little. I might have to pick another book. Start from the beginning. Introduction. Too early. What's this? Calories. I'm just talking about calories. Triggered. Speaking of calories, I'm so hungry. What time is it? It's like 3 o'clock. Okay, what is this? But at about month 25, we start seeing really measurable differences. Ooh, is this talking about losing weight? I think so. Perspective. Friend number three, 30 minutes, something instructional. Okay, let's go here. Brad, okay, not gonna judge the name. Brad ate only 125 more calories more a day in that same time frame and gained 33 and a half pounds in what time frame? Now he weighs 67 pounds more than Scott. Oh God, I feel like this is like a math test. How many like pounds did they lose together? I'm being negative. Let's read a positivity book. You Are Here by Thich Nhat Hanh. I hope I'm saying that right. I'm so sorry. This one is Discovering the Magic of the Present Moment. So this is a really great book. Oh, look, I have a bookmark in here. Shelf, what's this for? Anyways, let's start where I left off. The other. The first miracle of mindfulness is our true presence. Being here, present, and totally alive. Then, if you are really here, something else will also be here. The presence of the other. Oh, sounds kind of scary. You are here, and the other is here. What is the other? It could be your heart, your eyes, your body, or your breath. The other is the sunset, the song of the birds, or it could be your lover, your partner, your son, your daughter, or your friend. So the other is literally anything else. The other is the kingdom of God. If you are really here, solid and free, the kingdom of the kingdom of dog is God. Will also be here for you. The fundamental conditioning of blah 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 blah. Okay, let's go forward. Oh, I saw a little, what's it called? Bullet points. Let's go to the bullet points. The five elements. This is why I did not finish college. The five elements. Quote, I am here for you. End quote. It sounds very simple, but we should ask ourselves, what does I actually mean? The Buddha taught that I is a combination of the following five elements: our form, physical body, our feelings, our perceptions, our mental formations, our consciousness. These are called the five elements or aggregates. Moving on. So great. Oh, look, another little short part. Here is a practice poem you can learn by heart. Oh, look, see, this, you don't even need to read the whole book. You can just like skim and like figure it out. It can also be sung, which we're not gonna do because I can't sing. I can only sing when no one's looking or listening. Okay, and it goes. I have arrived. I am home. In the here, in the now. Okay, starting over. I have arrived. I am home. In the here and in the now. I am solid. I am free. In the ultimate, I dwell. What does that mean? You can use this poem during sitting meditation or during walking meditation. Walking meditations. Has anyone ever taken a walking meditation? I've tried to do a sitting meditation and all it does is make me fall asleep. But if I do a meditation, right, it normally turns into like a lucid dream. So if anybody hasn't lucid dreamed yet or is trying to, doesn't know how, start with meditating because it kind of forces you to be still for a really long time, which is also what you need to lucid dream. Or if you go, you know, you have to like start to make a habit of it. I like to look at my hands in my dreams because, you know, obviously you know what your hands look like. And if you look at them in a dream, they look off. And so you know you're dreaming. But you also have to be calm. So the first few times I realized I was lucid dreaming, I guess I got like so excited, I kind of like woke myself up. So that's just a pro tip. Find something consistently that you have to like think about it before you go to bed too. You're like, okay, I'm gonna like look at my hands. You know, you like start picturing something that you want to dream about and then look at your hands or whatever. And then once that happens, say, okay, I'm dreaming now and it's okay and I'm calm. And they can like start creating things, but like only for so long, because once again, like you'll just wake up. Let's read one more part of this. I like this book. Eclipse of the heart. Just kidding. I think they said epilepsy. Ooh. Maybe I should be reading more. Ooh, I saw something about love. Let's see. Cultivating true love. Four mantras. Wow, so it's like a spell book in here. Where's the bullet points? Where's the false perceptions? That's very true. Anyone that's ever had a crush understands what false perceptions is. Rip. Speaking of crushes, did anybody else ever have code names for, you know, their crush when they were in school? You know? Anybody? Just me? Because I had a nickname for everybody, and they were not even good. Like, as in, they were so obvious. But hold on, let me see if I'm running out of time, because this only lets me film for 10 minutes at a time, and I actually have no idea how much time is left on there. Alright, well, I'll just keep talking. I'll just tell you real quick. So one of them was White Shorts Guy. Because the first day we saw him, he was wearing white shorts. Another one was Mohawk Guy, because he had a faux hawk, actually. It wasn't a mohawk, so we were being slick with the name there. He was never going to know who we were talking about. It's just so silly to think of a time when I used to be so scared to talk to, like, guys that I thought were cute, you know? Just like getting all nervous. It's like I gotta miss those times. I talk about that with my boyfriend now, how back in those days we just used to get like so like excited and nervous, like you felt like you were gonna throw up. You just like, it's kind of like beautiful to be feeling all those emotions, you know? I don't know, I kind of miss it. But also it was terrifying every single day going to school and just having to deal with that. So I'm glad it's over. Also kind of miss it, but glad I'm here right now. So yeah, anyways, that was book club. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm going to be doing maybe more videos like this. You know what I should do? I'm gonna order Shane's book. We'll start there. Maybe Trisha's book too. I think hers is just an ebook, but Shane's book, and read parts of his book and like go